Made some pesto this morning. Cooked a little bit of tortellini. It's my favorite pasta with pesto is tortellini. Had so much basil in my backyard, so I got to do something with it. So, made a ton of pesto. One of my favorite things to make it so easy. Just put it in the food processor with some toasted pine nuts. Kind of toasted them a little too much today. Some garlic. You can use Pecorino Romano cheese, which is a little saltier than Parmesan. I used the Parmesan today. And what else? A little salt, olive oil, and you're good to go. It's just got an amazing fresh summer taste that very few people can resist in the summertime. I got a whole bunch of basil left over, and I'm gonna make a tomato salad, fresh Jersey tomatoes, coming up too in just a couple minutes. Okay. Now we have our fresh Jersey tomatoes. These are from a farm stand in Medford, New Jersey. Grabbed yesterday. I'm doing this quick because people are hungry. What I like to do is just cut it in half. We're good. Found a little container for it. Thank you so much. And I cut them in half and then slice them. Maybe you can present them whatever way you want, chunked, sliced. Important thing is that you get to eat them and taste what a real tomato tastes like in New Jersey this time of year, because it is the best thing out there. And you know, we're proud of it because we're from Jersey, but people in other states, other parts of the country, they also recognize it. I don't know if it's the soil, I don't know if it's the temperature, the sand content. South Jersey seems to have a little better quality of tomato. Maybe it's the sand in the soil. Some people might disagree with me, but Jersey tomatoes this time of year, you gotta take advantage of it. The best way to do it is the way I'm doing it right here, as long as I don't slice my finger off, is to put them in a plate, slice them up, get some fresh basil from the yard or from the market. A lot of farm markets are selling this stuff now in bulk. You can make pesto with it. Definitely don't let it go to waste to make a salad. The smell is amazing. I like to garnish it with it's a local spice called Papa Joe's. What it is salt, garlic powder, and black pepper. And then I would just put some olive oil. Where's my good olive oil? Oh, yeah. My stash, my private stash of good olive oil. And then you just want that. That's how can anything be more simple but yet more delicious? Now, you want a caprese salad or caprese salad? You add your fresh mozzarella. Now they make it in balls. I think I've said this before. They're making it in balls, in little balls, tiny balls, big balls. They're gonna make it shaped like bunny rabbits for Easter pretty soon. Fresh mozzarella. Use the, in this case, because I wanna add more to this salad, I'm using the tiny balls. Now, we're going beyond the caprese salad here and just giving it more of a Mediterranean feel, because I'm gonna add Kalamata olives and I'm gonna add artichoke hearts as well. Drain the olives, and you could come off like a big hero by throwing something like this together, because it looks so great, it tastes amazing, and people are like, oh my God, where'd you learn how to do this? I watched some dumb video with some dumb Guido named Dennis. So now, we found the artichoke hearts. Got a little jar of marinated artichoke hearts. All right, because you don't want to lose too much of the flavor of the tomato and bury with too many other things. A little Kalamata olives, a little bit of the artichoke hearts, perfect. Where are my paper towels? Most important ingredient in the kitchen, paper towels. All right, so we have the artichoke hearts, we have the Kalamata olives, we have the fresh Jersey tomatoes, we have fresh basil, we've put a little salt, pepper, garlic powder, olive oil, mwah, 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 as my grandmother would say. Fresh Jersey tomato salad, little kicked up, little spiced up, enjoy. Next, we're gonna go to our pesto and tortellini that we've heated up, and we're gonna serve it. So we reheated the, which is a big no-no in Italian households. Italian kitchens is reheat your pasta. But since we're at work here, reheated the pasta with the pesto, put a little chopped tomato on top, little garnished with a little basil, and we're about to serve it to the ungrateful troops here.